So I think this plant will probably blow your mind a little bit because this is actually a cactus in the cactaceae family. And I did a video on cactus and I had mentioned, and on cacti, and I had mentioned that cacti are more stems. They don't have, they don't really have leaves. And that's one of the ways that you could tell cacti apart. But of course there is an exception to every rule. And one of my very astute viewers had mentioned, well, what about Pereskia? And I was like, oh yes, of course. You know, there are exceptions to every rule probably in the plant world. And Pereskia, in this case, Pereskia weberiana, which is, you know, native to the South American region, and a lot of Pereskias are native to the Central and Central South America, I should say. A lot of taxonomists and botanists really believe that Pereskia is kind of like in the evolutionary history of plants, that it went from foliage plants to cacti, and in that process have lost their leaves as a way to be able to store water. So this is very interesting because this is kind of like that bridge plant. This is like the missing link. And if you actually go into this plant, you'll see that they do have aerials and they do have prickles, which you might not be able to see here because it's really hard and I can't get up close on this plant. Maybe if I could bring it up a little bit closer, you'll see that maybe there's some prickles that are coming out of these areas where the leaves are. And this is a type of plant that can withstand being in a little bit more direct light or full sun. I have this pulled back a little bit more into indirect light because unlike a regular cactus with just the stem, that is a huge water storage unit. It's lost its leaves, so it's not losing some of its water from its leaves. However, these do have leaves, so I'm a little bit more mindful of that. However, they are succulent and they have this kind of cuticular sheen on it, so it has this tendency to be able to keep in the water a little bit better than a typical plant that might not have that kind of epidermal or cuticular sheen to it. You'll also notice that I'm treating this very similarly to any other kind of succulent, so I'm giving this a bit more of an airy, well-draining succulent soil. I have it, a little bit of bonsai mixture in here. I have a little bit more higher of perlite, which is great. So when I water this plant, the water goes through thoroughly and gives this plant a really good drink, which more or less I'm kind of watering on a weekly basis. I should have noted that, like, you see these little brown bits right here at the end. I so wish I could have showed you this plant even just a few weeks ago because it was had a beautiful bloom, and the blooms don't really last that long. That's one of the ways that you could actually tell that it's a cactus from the type of bloom that it has. And it's pretty. It's like a pink bloom. It's nothing like really bombastic because sometimes you'll have cacti that have like these really bombastic blooms. This one is a little bit more, I would say, demure. I could go on and on about Pereskia, but I think it's like totally worthwhile to actually do a video just on Pereskia alone, and I'm not sure when I'll get around to it. But from my experience of growing this, they've been very amenable houseplants. They're not spectacular plants. I mean, if you do let this kind of grow out, it will grow into probably a giant picky bush. Because in the wild, like in this case in Bolivia where this is from, you do see them as kind of like large bushes. So you would have to kind of prune them to kind of keep them manageable and not from like pricking yourself on some of these little prickles right here in the base of the leaf blades. No pest pressures. I've been growing Pereskia for about 6 years. This one's one of my newer ones. So there hasn't been any pest pressures. You know, you think you'd see kind of mealybugs or maybe even some thrips or some scale, but I haven't had any of those problems whatsoever.